you know, unless Tom Cruise like parachutes into your house and like steals your password book.
Hello and welcome to Outside the Fox, where we explore what's happening online and why it matters. My name's AJ Patel.
And I'm Kim Horcher. AJ, have good news for you.
Okay.
The password may actually be dead.
Please, please, please tell me this is true, because you already know how much I struggle with the world of passwords.
Refresh us.
I'm someone that, you know, I just don't like doing the, I need to have one uppercase character and a couple of numbers and a special character.
You don't like memorizing gibberish?
I'm really bad, and everything has become, you know, just me always referencing the passwords tab and seeing, okay, you know, this is my password for this account, and how am I even supposed to remember any of this stuff?
Well, you might not have to much longer. I mean, I've been thinking lately too of why don't we have a strong alternative to passwords. It seems like they've always existed as long as computers, even before the internet existed. Why is this our only option?
Fair enough.
Right?
Today, we are talking about the death of the password, what's replacing it, and how we can make our digital lives much more secure.
Joining us today is our friend and yours, Steve Flavin. Hey, Steve.
What's up, everyone?
Give us a quick rundown on your take on passwords.
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm not a password expert by any means, but I'm just weirdly obsessed with them. I'm sorry to say that the death of the password is greatly exaggerated. Unfortunately, we're probably going to have to deal with passwords for the foreseeable future, but there is an alternative on the horizon that is worth trying to kind of anticipate. And, you know, as we're going to be talking about today, the future of passwords, which is passkeys.
Before we dive into passkeys, could you actually, you know, give us a little bit of information on why passwords are so vulnerable in the first place?
Yeah, well, I mean, look, the human brain isn't designed to memorize 400 passwords. That's number one, right? I actually just took a look at my current password manager. I have about 474 exactly passwords that are saved in there. And I don't think that's actually unusual. I think we all have probably hundreds of accounts. One, you know, major advantage actually of a password manager or software in order to catalog all of your accounts is just keeping tabs on where you've registered your personal information. And, you know, you're able to audit whether or not you actually use those accounts anymore. So this kind of where we started, you know, kind of the quandary, the dystopia, if you will, that we find ourselves in nowadays, where, you know, you really need to have some kind of a mechanism for keeping track of them, because you shouldn't be using passwords that you can remember, because those aren't very secure usually. Those are often easily guessed. You definitely should not absolutely under any circumstances be reusing passwords. So the only reasonable solution that's secure is to use, you know, either a third-party password manager or some kind of a password manager that's built into your browser or at the OS level.
So what is the difference between a passkey and a password?
In an ideal world, you don't need the password anymore. That instead of a password, that is something that even if it's a really secure password, there's, you know, a non-zero chance that it can be cracked, you know, with some kind of, you know, hacking software or password cracker. And so it's more secure, the theory is, to use some kind of biometric input like a scan of your face or your fingerprint. It's been in development for a few years now, but they're called passkeys. It's a new standard that's developed by the FIDO Alliance. It's designed to replace passwords with biometric or device-based authentication. So most commonly face ID or your fingerprint. And it syncs through, you know, iCloud, Google Password Manager, third-party tools. You know, that's one of the disadvantages of it actually is you need to have some kind of a software mechanism for keeping track of your passkeys. And it's tied to your device. And so that's one other disadvantage is that if you lose your device, ostensibly you have to go in to your account and deregister your device in order to, you know, make sure that nobody is, you know, nobody has access to that. If you have your device, like a mobile device where you log in with Face ID or a fingerprint, if you register a passkey with some kind of a platform or account that you log into, it connects to the information, the biometric information that you've granted to Apple or Google, whoever is the manufacturer of that device. The advantage of that is it's super secure. Like, you literally need that device and your fingerprint or your face in order to get into that device. You can have multiple devices that are logged into your passkey. So if you have, for instance, I have a recent laptop that has a fingerprint scanner. And so that would also work, and it would be, combined with your passkey credentials.
You kind of mentioned it earlier, as, we have so many more accounts than we originally did when we maybe first created a password. And so having, 400 accounts is impossible to keep up with when it comes to passwords. And this one passkey, your face, is inputting something into, let's say I'm logging into a streaming service on TV. Is that not still inputting, my password at the end of the day? So is it kind of just having that double authentication to keep me more secure?
I mean, that's what's happening now, quite frankly, is the rollout of passkeys. Even though they're intended to replace passwords, that's not exactly how they're being implemented right now. They're sort of being implemented as an additional layer of security on top of your existing password. The companies that I think are doing it well, there's three companies, and it's actually not shocking that they're doing it well because they all make OSs. Apple, Google, and Microsoft are all doing it pretty seamlessly. But your password is still it's still part of your account, and you can go in and change it. And ostensibly, your password can still be hacked, which was, again, the whole point of passkeys, was that you don't have a password, so there's nothing to hack. But right now, that isn't necessarily the case.
Speaking of how companies are rolling out passkeys, how is a platform like Firefox integrating passkeys currently?
We have a password manager that's built into Firefox, and we support passkeys. So it's just kind of an industry standard now at this point. It's kind of tricky with passkeys. With a password, theoretically, and we talked about this in our last episode where we talked about passwords, if you have a book of passwords, right? If you literally write down your passwords in a book, that's actually not as silly as it sounds. That's actually a fairly secure way to keep your passwords, because the likelihood of your password book getting hacked is almost non-existent. Unless Tom Cruise parachutes into your house and steals your password book, very unlikely that you're going to lose those passwords. It's not possible to record a passkey in a book. It has to be synced to the cloud, or you have to have some kind of a software mechanism for keeping track of all of your passkeys.
I mean, are there drawbacks to that though? Like you said, it is reliant on cloud software, and that's not 100% foolproof, not 100% up all the time.
Look, I mean, I would say it's not super essential right now, if I'm being perfectly honest. I think that if it's something that you're technically inclined, or you're, weirdly obsessed with, keeping up with passwords and, setting everything up, it's like a password 102 kind of graduation, where it's okay, I've set all of this stuff up. Now I can upgrade some of my accounts. And there aren't actually that many platforms that support them yet, in the grand scheme of things. But I would say that the advantage is that you're much less likely to have that login information compromised. Even if you were to lose your device, for instance, we talked about, if they don't have your face or your fingerprint, they're not going to be able to log into your device anyway. Although maybe that's another Mission Impossible style fictional scenario that we could dream up.
Seeing how the world of passwords have evolved, one biggest drawback, and I think you alluded to it earlier, is, if I'm trying to use my phone to take a Face ID scan and it might be too dark or one eye is closed, then I can put in my iPhone password to access that as an alternative. That's one drawback that I've thought about, but have you run into any of that?
Yeah, I mean, I'm actually super curious if the idea of having a passcode to open your phone is eventually going to become old hat. It's at some point, once there's, statistically nearly 100% user adoption of using some kind of biometric information to log into your account, that essentially becomes your password. I think that that's the sort of, like, in terms of future casting, that's perhaps the goal. You know, other content that we made on the Firefox channel, we've actually talked about passphrases, is a way of creating a password that is hard to guess, but is still secure and is still something that you might be able to memorize. But it's one of those things that you can't memorize 400 of those, right? So the idea is, like, there's just a couple of, like, you know, really important accounts, like your device, your computer, your password manager, maybe your bank, you know, that you can count on one hand. And then the rest, you should ideally have some kind of a mechanism. I think for the foreseeable future, there will always need to be passwords as an alternative login solution. Whether that is actually something that's required, if you have an alternative way to log in, like a passkey, that remains to be seen.
That's a great point, is, like, you know, even if this technology is evolving, the adoption may not be fully there, and there still has to be an alternative. So, you know, we're speaking about the death of the password. It may still be kicking in a couple of years' times.
Well, it seems like the password isn't so dead just yet, but what can I do to get ahead of the curve at least? Is it time to start using passkeys?
The path that we're on, you know, with 400 passwords and, you know, like, people reusing passwords, and, you know, it's just, like, it's not really sustainable. Maybe it's always going to be a dumpster fire in terms of just, you know, like, going forward, and I think the onus is on these tech companies rolling out the implementation of passkeys in order to make it palatable to regular people. Flashing forward, I don't know, 50 years, 100 years, like, the idea that we're still entering in characters into a device or a computer, like, feels, like, it already feels old-fashioned, and it just opens itself up to so many mistakes, and you know, it's just not super secure if you get right down to it, the way that most people, like most regular people, implement it, because they just don't want to be bothered. And it's really just, it's interesting to kind of look back on, like, how we got here. I don't know what the future of the password looks like, but I think that right now, like, you know, if we flash forward a few decades, I think it would be sad if we're still doing this, the same thing that we are now. So hopefully we move in the direction of something that's a little bit more streamlined and less, you know, tied to our phone numbers and email addresses, which is another thing that's, you know, it's like you can never change your email because everything is tied to, you know, accounts that you've made that sometimes you've forgotten about. We need to have a more streamlined way of keeping track of all of this stuff. Rant over. Thank you for coming to my TED Talk.
All right, Steve. Thank you for enlightening us with all of this information and recontextualization to help us not really be so ready for the death of the password. Thanks for joining us, Steve.
Anytime.
For the audience, we want to hear from you. Let us know in the comments, what have you done to start going passwordless? Subscribe to the channel and be sure to download Firefox, because you know it's the best. We'll see you next time.